Hi, let's welcome you for the Dimensions online test series platform. We're going to discuss paper 9 of English. Okay, question number 76, which best expresses the meaning, right? You need to find out the meaning of the given word. What does the word decimated means? Kill, destroy, or remove a large proportion of. Okay, now let's look at the meanings. Captured means imprisoning someone or detaining someone. So these words mean capture, a detain or imprison. Destroyed means demolished. Damaged, which again means damaging something, but it's not total demolishing or destruction, just a damage. Now worried means bothered, concerned or upset, disturbed. Okay, so among the words, which will be the correct answer? Decimated. So the correct word which is synonymous to the word decimated is destroyed. Now 77, which is opposite in meaning to the given word. I need to find out the word which is opposite in meaning. Invincible means unconquerable, unattackable, or unassailable or invulnerable. Okay, so all these words means the same. Impregnable means again unconquerable, indomitable, unbeatable. Okay, omnipresent, omni, which means all. We learned this while we were discussing root words. Omni means all, present means presence. Okay, omnipresent, present everywhere. Next, powerless, having no power. Potent means someone who is forceful or dominant or powerful, strong. So all these words mean the same, potent. Now, invincible means something, someone who is unconquerable, who is, it is very difficult to beat him. And powerless is having no power. So it will be opposite meaning to the word invincible. So the opposite word should be powerless. Next one, 78. Choose the correctly spelled word. So the correctly spelled word is diarrhea. So D-I-A-R-R-H-O-E-A, which means lose motions. Next, 79 to 81 are spotting the error questions. Okay, spotting the error in the given sentence. Now 79, it took her a long time to get off the death of her husband. So to get, it's not get off, it should be to get over. Means it took her a long time to get over the tragedy of her husband's death. So get over. Next, it is best to be silent than to speak in anger. So here two things are being compared. One is being silent, the other one is speaking something when you are in anger. So because when you are in anger, you don't have control with your words. You will speak whatever comes to your mind, right? So you won't be having control. So here two things are being compared. So whenever two things are being compared, what do you need to use? Comparative degree. So, and the one clue that suggests us that we need to use comparative degree is the word than to speak in error. So speak in anger, before that to be silent. So these two things are compared. So which is preferable? To be silent is preferable. So how can I use? It is better to be silent than to speak in anger. So better is the word instead of best that can be used here. It is better. Next, so the erroneous part is part A. His father is disgusted against him for his addiction to drink. So disgusted always follow with disgusted. The word is always followed by or succeeded by the preposition with. So disgusted with. Okay, so option B is erroneous. Part B is erroneous. Now 82 to 84, you need to fill the blanks with an appropriate word. The aim of a peace council is dash rather than cure. So that should be definitely preservation. The aim of a peace council is preservation than cure. So salvation will also mean the same, preservation or conservation, but contextually preservation is correct, but not salvation. Okay, so what is a preservation? Salvation means preservation from harm or loss. Okay, Next. He gives everyone dash the class opportunities for practice. He gives everyone in the class. Means, what does mean here? He is giving the opportunities for everyone in the class. So, in the class. In is the right preposition to be used there. Next. Harish soon gained dash in English. Generally, what you gain in languages, you gain proficiency, right? So, proficiency is the correct one. Provincialism means lack of sophistication. And efficiency, you know. Eminency is a high elevation. So, generally, you gain proficiency in the languages you speak. So, proficiency is the correct. Next. Idioms or phrases, and you need to find out the meaning of those idioms. The first one, beggar description. Beggar description means something that cannot be described. So, option A. Next, drag one's feet. Drag one's feet means be reluctant to act. Option C. Then, hope against hope. Hoping against a hope means something very difficult to hope. So, which one would be the correct one? Nurture an impossible hope. Option C. Next, 88 to 90, you need to find out the word which can be substituted for the given sentence or phrase. Now, lack of skill. Someone is having no skill. Okay, let's look at the options. Inertness means, we already seen in the last paper, I guess, inactivity. Insistence. Insistence means urging, request continuously. So, the request which are pouring continuously. So, that is called insistence or demand, urging, or you can use exhortation. So, these are the words which are synonymous to that. Ineptness means lacking or showing a lack of skill. So, there is no skill or he doesn't have a skill. Okay. Insolence. Insolence means rude and disrespectful behavior. So, among the ones, which one is the word that could be substituted for the given sentence? Ineptness. Next. Stick with a thick end used in a mortar for pounding. So, thistle means a plant. Stifle. Stifle means to suffocate. Scepter. Scepter means an ornamented staff. Next. Pestle. A heavy tool with rounded end. So, which one is the correct one? Correct word that can be substituted for the given sentence? It is pestle. Next, an act when people vote in order to make a decision about a particular subject or policy rather than voting for a person. For example, in elections, what do? You vote for a person. In by-election, what do? If something happens to the elected candidate and there will be or any misconduct in the election of a candidate happens, so then what do? Generally go for a by-election, right? In by-election, is generally conducted if a candidate demises, right? So, again, you are electing a person there. And exit poll, you know, generally people will be voting for a particular person or particular government. Then, after election and prior to result, there will be an exit poll. It's based on a little kind of survey, right? So, that is called as exit poll or opinion poll. And a referendum, you know. Referendum is, it's again official. So, this exit poll is not official. It's just conducted by some private parties, right? So, referendum means, recently you have seen a referendum, Brexit referendum. So, what happened there? UK want to exit the European Union, right? So, for that, they conducted a referendum from the people. So, then people voted for it. And based on the percentage of vote, so what people opt for, according to that, Britain had exited, UK has exited from the European Union. So, that is called referendum. So, see, an act when people vote in order to make a decision about a particular subject or policy rather than voting for a person, for a subject or a policy. So, here the referendum is a subject or policy that UK to be remain in European Union or UK should be opt to out of European Union. That's the subject there. And people had voted for accordingly the result was it exit the European Union. So that's what Brexit referendum mean. Okay, so that is a referendum. So that could be the best example to exemplify you what referendum is. Next, 91 to 95, a sentence, a part of the sentence is underlined, four alternatives are given, and you need to find out the word that could improve the sentence if it improves, else no improvement. Jane had told me that she hasn't done her homework. She hasn't done her homework. Insists me that you need to use something which is in present tense, in the underline. But there it is, past perfect. So how can I replace it with? I can replace it with a present tense, which is in present tense, a verb which is in present tense. Now Jane is a singular, third person singular, so I need to add S. So Jane tells me that she hasn't done her homework. Tells is the one that can be the improvised version of the given underlined part. 92. This survey is concerning your health as well as that of your family. It's not concerning. This survey is concerned with your health. So option B is the correct one. Excuse me. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden. Is there a need of improvement there? No. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden. That's correct. Absolutely correct. So no improvement. A black and white goat were gazing. So a black and white goat was gazing. If it was like was gazing, then I could have understand the black and white is the characteristic of goat because the goat is in the color of black and white. So I could have assumed myself, right? But the word were used after the blank specifies me that that is a plural. So whenever that is a plural, then you need to make it sense as a plural thing, right? So how can I make it look like? How can I make it look like a plural noun? So a black and a white goat were gazing. So now it makes sense. So option B is correct. I had took the papers to John's office. So there is no need of had took. Okay. So it should be took the papers. I took the papers to John's office. Next passage. Tryst with destiny. What does tryst means? Tryst means a private encounter. Okay. A tryst with destiny was a speech delivered by Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of independent India, to the Indian Constituent Assembly in Parliament on 14th August 1947. It is considered to be one of the greatest speeches of all times and to be a landmark oration. Oration means oratory. So someone who is talking, right? Who is speaking about something. That captures the essence of the triumphant culmination of the largely non-violent Indian independence struggle against the British Empire in India. What does the word triumphant mean? It means victorious. Culmination means culminate to a highest point or to reach a pinnacle or to reach the climax or something that is best of the process. Okay? Long years ago, we made a tryst with our destiny and now time comes when we shall redeem our pledge, not wholly or in full measure, but very substantially. Freedom and power bring responsibility. The responsibility rests upon the assembly. A sovereign body, sovereign means who have supreme powers of ruling something. A sovereign body representing the sovereign people of India. The service of India means the service of the millions who suffer. It means the ending of poverty and ignorance. Ignorance means lack of knowledge or information. And disease and inequality of opportunity. We cannot encourage communalism or narrow-mindedness. For no nation can be great whose people are narrow in thought or in action. To the people of India, whose representatives we are, this is no time for petty and destructive criticism. Petty means unimportant. No time for ill will or blaming others. We have to build a noble mansion. Noble means honorable. Mansion means stately home. A free India where all her children may dwell or live in, reside, settled, whatever it may be. So dwell means live in, reside, settled. Okay. 96th question. To whom did Nehru deliver this famous speech? Nehru delivered this famous speech to the members of the Constituent Assembly. That was written in the passage, right? So option B. Choose the answer which captures Nehru's belief. So Nehru believed that India could take huge steps towards realizing its dreams. So option C, the most dominant voice in the speeches. So what can you find? What is the soul or tone of the passage? It is optimism, right? So the voice of optimism is the correct option. Next, 99. Select the answer which best reflects Nehru's point of view. So Nehru believed that communalism would be dangerous for India. Yeah, that was mentioned in the passage. So option C, that's the right one. And finally, what mansion did Nehru want to see built? So it was clearly noted there, noble mansion of free India, right? So noble means honorable, honorable mansion. So Nehru believed that the honorable mansion of India should be built. That is your option B. Yes, with this we finish paper 9 and we see the next paper explanation in the next part. Thank you. Have a good day.